Okay, so what we're teaching now is defining balance, true balance, in the saddle. If we have our hands on the reins and we're trying to balance ourselves on the horse's head, we're sending false communications and cues to the horse by him not touching the reins. Now all of a sudden he's finding balance in his seat, in his saddle, and he's finding his own balance. Make sense?